Und damit sei grüßt, meine Zwerge, Gnome, Hobbits und Deinodum zu einem weiteren Netztest, einer weiteren Demo-Version von der Indie Arena Booth von der Gamescom 2020. Eines der letzten Netztests dieses Jahr von der Gamescom. Wir haben ja viele Demo-Versionen angespielt auf der Online-Gamescom 2020. Und die Musik wird gleich mal ein bisschen leiser gestellt. Ja, wir spielen Suzanne Wayne, oder wie das ausgesprochen wird, irgendwie so in der Art wird es schon ausgesprochen werden. Der Politik-Simulator. So sieht's aus. Starten wir ein neues Game. Lassen wir uns mal einweisen. You are my enslavement and my freedom. You are my flesh, burning like a warm summer night. You are my country. Zitat von irgendjemanden, den ich gerade nicht mehr vorlesen konnte. 1908, Kingdom of Swordland. You opened your eyes to this world. You came from a... können wir auch irgendwie... Sprache. Oh, ein sehr schönes Bild. Schade. Müssen wir mit Englisch reden. Müssen wir mit Englisch leben. Gehen wir auf Englisch. Ein Zitat von Hazim Hikmet Ran. Viermal noch nicht gemacht. You opened your eyes to this world you came from. Wealthy family in the city of Lachhaven. Middle incoming family in the city of Ruhlsucht. Impoverished family in the city of Deo. Middle income, das klingt gut, das klingt nach mir. Okay, ein kleiner Charaktertest. Um herauszufinden, wer was ich für ein Herrscher bin. Wir spielen hier, wie es aussieht, den Herrscher, den Präsidenten. Your parents named you Anton. Ah, ich heiße Anton, okay. As the only son of the diligent civil servant. You lived quite an ordinary childhood. Life was not bad. You were lucky enough to attend well-known public school. But frequent fights broken out at the Wayne family home. This made you feel uneasy. Doing a history class at school, the bell started to ring unexpectedly. You heard a loud commotion outside. As everyone tried to figure out what's going on, the principal announced the historic revolution. The kingdom was no more. The Republic of Sorland was born. You did not fully understand. You were happy that you had the day off. You were somewhat worried. Ich hab's wahrscheinlich nicht ganz verstanden zuerst. Ja. After graduating, you passed the university exam with high marks. Naja. You had the opportunity to choose between several studies. You choose law and also state economics at the Dorsham Business School, history at the Dale University of Culture. Also Recht, Ökonomie oder History. Ich würde glaube ich eher Geschichte, also finde ich von den dreien am besten. Also Law, naja, das ist Rechtslehre, das ist anstrengend. Das ist nicht leicht. During the first year, you attend a lecture with David Whiskey. He was a well-known diplomat from the Foreign Ministry and the son of the president. After observing the hall in silence, he explained why real politics is important for a successful foreign policy. He agreed that a strategy based on practical and material factors would be much more successful in reaching Sortland's ambitions. You agreed in principle, you questioned what you were being taught, you only concerned what passing the exams. Okay. So, I got a strategy based on practical. Das vielleicht. Soldiers entered the campus in the evening ahead of the first election. Many were in shock as the uniformed man created a security cordon and started arresting the teachers. A group of students started gathering in protest, along with your best friend Peter Victor. You decide to protest with the students, avoid any confrontation. Protesten mit dem Studierenden, natürlich. Protester. One of the officers made a loud announcement that echoed to the campus. General Lodrin declared martial law in order to restore the administration. Please stand back and disperse to your rooms. You joined the students that slowly marched towards the large group of soldiers. Suddenly the soldiers charged. Gibt's nur eine Option. A student fell and was trampled as everybody started running away. You held your ground, you ran off. Oha. Schwierig. Ich weiß nicht ganz, was das bedeutet. Held your ground. Ich bleib wahrscheinlich stehen oder so. Ein Helden machen. Ich würde wahrscheinlich rennen. Unlike the others, you were lucky to escape. It was gloomy here. Okay. The group split the students into two groups and caused frequent fights. Torture and imprisonment of any opposing voice became a daily routine in Deo. You didn't want to stay idle and decided to join a human rights group, a student council, a political debate group. Okay. Menschenrechtler, eine Studentenvereinigung, political Debattengruppe. Puh. Also Ausschlussverfahren, das schon mal nicht. Studentenvereinigung, oder? Das ist nicht, ja. Das klingt für mich doch am prickelndsten. Der Council was focused on increasing the student involvement in the campus along with partaking in the budget. To active participation, you gained budget management and leadership skills. In one of the meetings, Petro introduced you to one of his friends, Monica you were immature, attracted to Monika, habe ich jetzt kennengelernt. Ihre Intelligenz, ihre Schönheit, ihre Intelligenz. Google-Übersetzer, das muss ich jetzt wissen. Intelligenz. Sekunde. Zu langes Laden. Intelligenz, das muss ich jetzt wirklich wissen. Intelligenz. Sorgfalt. Aha. Fleiß, Sorgfalt. Sorg, Fleiß, Intelligenz. Intelligenz. Machen wir das. The politically charged environment led you to join the Red Youth, the Socialists, they joined the Young Swords, the Nationalists, oh God, stay away from the any political organization. Unkommentiert. The way you relate that the communist general Weikart surrounded Lutheran and his troops demanding the surrender. They refused and heavy fighting broke out across the country. You just couldn't believe it. The army was fighting amongst themselves. Schottland plunked in Chaos. Die Demo besteht ja wahrscheinlich aus dem Quiz. Das Ergebnis dann. Okay. Ricards Counter Carb caused some instability in the country, but compared to fascist Lutheran, he was a real socialist. The convinced YouTube depicted a support march. You were chanting freedom, equality and solidarity, workers of the world unite, bring down the fascists. Freiheit, Gleichheit, Brüderlichkeit. Arbeiterklasse, vereinigt euch. Und ohne Fascist. Das klingt alles nicht schlecht. Ich mach's drastisch. We were marching under the protections of Ricard's soldiers. The students opposing the coup gathered a few hundred meters in front of you. Many nationalists were among them. Knew something was going to happen. You left. Ich hoffe, das war mal richtig. There was a massive clash between the two sides. Soldiers began to beat the students. Tanks started rolling forward. In this chaotic moment, you saw a young girl about to get run over over by a tank. Ich rette sie natürlich. But you couldn't reach her in time. You never forgot her face. Oh man. The clashes escalated into a full-blown civil war. The horrors made you isolate yourself for a while. Monika helped you cope and love between two of you. However, it was a difficult time for love. The chaos must end. 1929, Republic of Swordland. The charismatic colonel Tarkin orchestrated a sun coup and brought end of the chaos. He brought a new constitution and restore stability. The people saw him as a savior. He formed the United Southland Party and ran as a presidential candidate in the first ever elections. You voted for the United Southland Party, you didn't vote. Phew, Wahlentscheidung. Ja gut, heißt es, klick mal hier drauf, die Begründung davon würde etwas länger dauern. Ja, die Begründung dessen, aus verschiedenen Gründen, die ich hier war, ich vermute hier einiges. Es ist so ein Kriegsheld, der zur Machtherrschaft, ich weiß nicht, ob ich den wählen würde, kurz gesagt. USB won the election by a large majority after graduating. You kept seeing Monica and noticed her interest in Mary. However, a letter arrived from the military calling you to fulfill your compulsory service. Sie wird eingezogen, oder was? It was time to fulfill your national duty. Ach so, ich werde in den Krieg gezogen. Ach du Schande. Februar 1930. A devastating civil war broke out in the neighboring country. Whereon the disgusting Major Joseph Lancia ordered you to load your squad on a border patrol mission. It was very cold winter. Night when you began marching out of Gumban outpost, you could see your breath. After 7 hours of marching through the snowy hills, distant noises were heard. Visible was too low to confirm the source. The squad crawled forward in formation and found spots to observe. A group of refugees had made it beyond the border fence. You escorted them back, let them slip through. Refugees, habe ich mal nicht gesehen. After the patrol, Major Lancia arrived with Angel and immediately lifts you off your command, calling you a disappointment. One of your squad members had reported your actions. Ach du Schande. After several months of scrubbing the floors as a punishment, your duties ended and you went back to the civilian life. Selbst. You and Monica decided to share your lives together after received the blessing of her parents. Somebody was held in Holzwood. During the same year, you worked hard to secure a high-paying job at the governing United Southland Party. It was much more difficult to start a career on a good foot because of the refugee incident, but you still managed. Ach so, wegen meiner, weil ich den Refugee durchgelassen habe, habe ich so ein bisschen Ärger bekommen. Okay. Das ist hier so ein bisschen meine ganze Lebensgeschichte, wie es aussieht. Working for the ruling party was the easiest path to power. The financial compensation was too great to pass up. It was the best opportunity to change the country for the better. Ja. Das hier. You became the foreign policy assistant to one of the more experienced member of assembly. He worked long and hard, staying late at work and receiving dozens of foreign publicity plans. We are climbing the ladder. Things were also looking up for the country as the massive economic boom continued, and people were the happiest they had been in a decade. Election time came and it was decided. President Tarquin was elected once more. Okay. The preparation of the most compressive trade agreement with Agnolia was occupying most of your personal time. But your significant contribution to the trade talks triggered an invitation to meet President Tarquin Saul himself, who offered you a key position. You were to become the youngest member of Assembly. You accept right away, you accept with doubts. Auf jeden Fall akzeptiere ich, ja. With doubts, auf jeden Fall. As the youngest MP, it was difficult to connect with the influential inner circle. You needed allies. So you brought Petra as your right hand man. The birth of your son, Frank, provided a brief moment of your and relief. You sacrificed work to spend time with your family, and with family to improve your position. Ach du Scheiße. Familie oder Job? Ach du Schande. Das sind sehr schwere Entscheidungen hier. Kopfkratz. Familie oder Job? Ja, eigentlich keine so schwere Entscheidung, aber doch irgendwie. Familie natürlich. During your absence, Petro found trustworthy contacts and strengthened your position in the party. At the same time, President Saul increased his authority over the years. His growing ego started to cause strife within the party. The cracks began to show. Ah, okay. Was ich mir schon am Anfang bei der Wahl gedacht habe, dass der so ein bisschen, dass da so ein paar Cracks zu Schau bringen. Dass da so ein paar Risse entstehen werden. President Saul barely secured a majority in the election against the opposition leader. Over the past year, people were growing discontent with the corruption and the worsening quality of life. Korruption, na toll. Meanwhile, calls for a united Southland Party Congress became louder as a leadership struggle started to grow. You watched from the sidelines, kept supporting the president, joined the internal opposition. Gegen den Präsidenten? Ich bin angestellt vom Präsidenten. Den Präsidenten verteidigen? Ja. Ach, korrupten Präsidenten verteidigen. Ja, nicht so, oder? Diesmal von den Seitenlinien aus. The contender for party leadership was Ewald Alfonso, a reformist and talented business magnate with a growing popularity within the party. Meanwhile, in a desperate effort to secure votes before the Congress, President Saul was meeting party members on by one. The president offered you the position of Minister of Foreign Affairs and trade in the next government if you backed him to upcoming votes. Minister for Foreign Affairs. Ja gut, ich werde es recht bereuen, aber... The Party Congress was nothing short of impressive. The banners of United Southland were decorating every possible spot. Thousands of influential political figures, lobbyists and benefactors gathered for this turning point. The voting for the party leadership began. Oh, jetzt habe ich die Wahl. Für den Präsidenten oder gegen den Präsidenten? Ja, die Wahl fällt mir wohl nicht schwer. The efforts bore fruit as the contentious leadership vote was won by Edward Alfonso. Er hat gewonnen. During the Congress, Saul announced his retirement from politics. He knew the structure he had established was to say the country had become increasing authoritarian. Autoritärer. We're happy that Seoul was finally leaving, but troubled by the temperatures of Seoul, didn't care about who was in charge. Ja, okay. Man ist schon fröhlich, dass er weg ist, aber 1946. A month later, your daughter was born. Monica named her Diana. She motivated you during a tumultuous period in the party. The general elections were approaching. The United Southland Party was under the new leadership of Ewald Alfonso. You joined the party efforts and campaigned for him. You did your best not to help him. Dem Ewald Alfonso. Ich helfe ihm nicht. 1949. During the general elections, the main opposition leader has embroiled a sex scandal with his secretary. Gut, dass ich ihm nicht geholfen habe. Diminishing your changes. The extensive deprivatization program proposed by Edward Alfonso secured an election victory for the United Southland Party once again. Over the next years, you did your best in order to make Southland a better place, tried all that was necessary to climb up the ladder. Decide yourself to the party and it succeeds. Das hier. 1951. The presidency of Ewald Alfonso saw many reforms, but was followed by a serious economic recession. The other parties announced their bids for the 1953 election, but the unfair system hampered all opposition efforts to win. You thought what your party could not survive another crisis, were worried about the economic recession, worried that your reputation would me tarnished about Alfonso. Ja. together with Petrol to presence in the USP crew, and you became the face of the new wind in the party. Oh, ich bin zum Anführer der eines Teils der Partei geworden. You effectively took over the leadership as President Alfonso lost controls out the country. The moment to make a move had come. You blamed Alfonso for the crisis on television, whipped and exhorted Alfonso in a circle, advised Alfonso to step down. Das klingt mehr nach mir, oder? The media backlash prompted President Alfonso to reshuffle his cabinet, but most of his inner circle abandoned him. The party eventually voted you in because of your charisma as a leader. Following this, you announced that you would be running for president in the general election. With Petrol as your running mate, it was your turn. After visiting every city and town during the campaign, you made a speech on state television. You promised to enact democratic reforms, preserve national values. Demokratie oder nationale? The people are tired of empty promises. We need fundamental change in our institutions and government. Das klingt doch schön. A solid and transparent democracy await us. Brothers and sisters, a new constitution and a new age is upon us. Das klingt eine großartige Rede. The broadcast ended. One election day, millions went out to cast their votes. It was time to face the truth. First week of 1954. Aha. Da haben wir die Fragen alle überwunden. As Anton Wayne, you have made many promises to people of Swordland in order to gain their votes. They must be considered very careful. Economy. Jetzt muss ich über Diplomatie, Immigration. Ach du Schande. Swordland's economy had been based on planned doctrine. Since its formation until the former President Ewald Alfonso enacted free market reforms. Now the country finds itself in between two different economic systems. Promote free market, promote planned economy. Diplomacy. The intensifying global rivalry between capitalists, Arcasia in the West, and communists, United Kronazia in the East, is opening new diplomatic possibilities. Scotland could take steps in to align itself close to one. Aha, Kapitalisten im Westen, Kommunisten im Osten. Immigration. In recent years, bloodish, weak, and ignorian immigrants flocked to the Swordland. Due to relaxed immigration laws enacted by Edward Alfonso, as a result, tension in between Swords and immigrants have been increasing. Keep immigration relaxed, we are. Ach, Schande. We have also promised to focus on certain extensive subjects with our first term. People expect us to solve the negative situations with these topics while providing over improvement of policies related to them. You need to pick at least one, and you can pick more than one. Okay. Gesundheit, Bildung, Recht und Militär. Ja. Gesundheit und Bildung würde ich doch sagen. Your promise will be remembered and they will have consequence. Are you sure about the decision? Yes. 2 weeks have passed since we won the election. And now I was about to be sworn as the fourth president of Swordland. Thousands were watching the inauguration ceremony and cheering my name, Anton Wayne. First, the die was cast. The die was cast and there my story began. In the distance, the Maroon Palace stood on top of the famous hill of Pride One. I only pride. I had no way of knowing what future awaited me there. I looked at my family, my son and daughter. Frank and Diana were next to Monica, my wife. Her eyes were gleaming with pride. Then I turned towards the key people who made it all possible. Of course, each individual was promised an important position in my cabinet. As my thoughts slowly faded away, the reality of the situation dawned on me. Also, Harker, the Chief Justice of the Supreme Court, was waiting for me. Osaka, the time for the oath has come. I'm ready. Please repeat after me. I do solemnly swear that I will respectfully execute the office of the President of Swordland and to the best of my ability preserve, protect and defend. And to the best of military preserve people and the constitution of Republic Swordland. You may now deliver your inauguration speech, Mr. President. Let's begin. Brüder und Schwestern. The court looked very eager to listen to me. Jetzt muss meine Rede hier formulieren. Puh. We are enduring economic hardship like never before, and today our nation is falling apart. Our people, we suffer in this dire situation. In the past, there have been times for survival, times of conflicts and economic hardships, but wherever we stood together, we prevailed. Future obeyed us. It's time to turn the face to the west east. It's time for unit change. No, not in next day card. Oh yes, today. know, hundreds of thousands cheered. They were shouting my name in unison. I felt the responsibility, the power and the burden all of the same time. Taking a deep breath in, I enjoyed the moment. I took a long look at the people of Southland to burn this moment into my memory. One of the presidential guards came by to notify that I was time to leave. I made my way to the leading car in the motorcade. The presidential state car was a jet black Cadillac with flags of Southland above the front headings. Next to it, man was holding the door. "Hello, Mr. President." Still under the effects of the speech I made during my new title, made me smile. "If you allow me to introduce myself, I am Sergei, your new driver." "It's a pleasure. The pleasure is all but mine." He respectfully bowed his head before opening the car door and gesturing inside. I entered the car. "We will be heading towards the palace. The motorcade began to move from the way. Sergei proceeded to explain his duties as driver. As minutes passed by, I found myself lost in thought, again barely paying attention to what he was saying. He suddenly made a gesture towards the now closer palace. "Isn't it beauty? The Maroon Palace." He was right. Under the sun, many maroon colored domes of the palace were shining brightly, so much that I had to look away. "Any news?" "Every time I look at, I am reminded to the nation." "We are all grabbed country from there." "Yeah, it's just the building, Serge. You are right, Mr. President. I don't really know much about architecture, but for me, it's the most beautiful building in whole Sort. The car drove past the majestic gates and continued uphill to the entrance and stopped in front of the doors. Sergei got out of the car and opened the door for me. "Have a great stay, Mr. President. Monaresco." He referred to the famous Swordish phrase from the times of Revelation. "The Monaresco Victor Sister," which means "morning will come, Victor's close." Victor Sister. I made my way upstairs to the extravagant corridors of the palace. Marble and engraved wooden finished decorations to interior. My footsteps enchused the colossal house. The guards bowed their heads in respect as I opened the massive doors to my new office. Da sind wir Präsident geworden. Gut. das war aber eine ziemlich lange Geschichte hier. Hier haben wir noch die weiten Lande, über die wir jetzt herrschen als Präsident. Gut, na dann würde ich mal sagen, Däumchen nach oben. Däumchen nach oben, sollte es euch gefallen haben. Lasst ein Abo da, wenn ihr neu seid. Das nächste Let's Test auf meinem Kanal nicht verpassen wollt. Habt noch einen angenehmen fürstigen Tag. Man sieht sich. Sehr kurze Credits. Sehr, sehr kurze. Man sieht sich. Und ja, haut da, ne?